is within the framework of law, whether the price which is proposed in this PPA or which is proposed to the regulator, whether it is a derived cost or it is a MOU cost or it is a competitive bidding cost, because it is very necessary for the regulator to see that, okay, any PPA which is happened between the seller and the buyer, it should be within the law framework, and then the prices should be the lowest prices, because if you want to evaluate that, so this kind of things you have to keep in mind. But ultimately we have to see that the role is to developmental, our role is developmental, so we will see that how the renewable energy should be promoted in our countries. So I will give this floor to Vivek Mishra to explain the case. Vivek.
Thank you, sir. So somebody is going to put up the case on the screen, or I just go and explain the viewpoint that I have put across?
If you like, you can put yourself.
No, so do you want me to share it on the screen, or yeah, I just, or that. People you are having, or everybody has it, so I can just take them through?
People have a copy, because they have been, this has been shared yesterday evening.
Okay.
But if you like, you can just bring it so that easy people can easily understand.
Yes, you can share, please.
Okay, I'll do that. Just a minute. I can't really see where it is. I don't know. Why can't I see it?
Mr. Vivek, if you are having any issue, we can share it from our end. No issues.
Please do that. You know, I can't just locate it right now. Although
no problem. I'm sharing.
So I'll cancel. Yeah, please do that. It's done. Yeah. That's it. Can I begin now?
Yes, sir, please start.
Yeah. Okay. So I have produced a case study which is hypothetical, but it is based on the very realistic situation, and it is about the procurement of renewable energy by a distribution licensee. I've named it ABC in a state, and it is and it has made a petition or a request before the regulator to approve 10 megawatt procurement of renewable energy. There are a lot of factual and the other information that is provided. So all the stakeholders have to actually look at the information that is there and have to analyze from their own perspective. So perspective is important to look at the information. So I know some information reinforces the case, some information would go against the petition. So we have to actually have a very balanced view, and then according to our own interest group, we'll have to look at the case. Which is on your screen as of now. This is the network and other information which we have provided. So you look at it, that, you know, what is the information. Then there is information which is on the consumer base, the connected load and the growth and all. So you can see that this utility is growing utility, and it has increasing demand. Can you come down below? Can you just move on to the... And you see that, you know, the essential point is that its energy demand and peak demand is 404 megawatt. There is a growth in demand. So it is, as you can see, that there is a requirement of power, and also in terms of both the power and the energy also, it is growing. So you see that, you know, there is energy requirement which is also there. There are losses as well. And remember that when you're looking at the price, it is ex-bus price. So when you are looking at computing the price, which is for the consideration of the consumers and consideration of the regulator, it is the price at which it is getting delivered. So just for your sake, I'm sort of informing you that when you're computing the price at the delivered point, you're also considering these losses. So So the price will go up by this percentage when you talk of the delivered price. There is certain RPO obligation. RPO means there is renewable purchase obligation. So the distribution licensee, as per the regulations framed by the state regulator, is supposed to buy 3.6% from the renewable energy. So whatever your total sale is, for example, your total sale is 177.536 MUs. Out of the 3.6% should be procured from the RPO, this renewable, and that's your obligation. But the current RPO obligation compliance is only 1.2%. So obviously, the regulator will push the distribution licensee that it has to procure from renewable energy sources to bridge that gap. And if it in case it continues to procure lower than what is mandated, there is a penalty provision of 1.50 per unit of the shortfall in the energy. In terms of the power portfolio, the average power purchase price is 3.48 rupees. This is the average of all the power which is procuring. The maximum tariff which is procuring is 4.10 rupees. So it is very important to you to sort of understand that this is the current cost of power procurement, and then relatively at what price the DISCOM is willing to purchase now, how does it stand, you know, because that will form a justification for your procurement. Can you come down, please? Yeah. So, and the minimum price at which is procuring is 2.20 rupees. Now, these are some factual, picture that has been created. There is recently a distribution licensee which has procured a similar amount of solar energy, and the price at which they procure is 2.40 rupees, and that is again, as I mentioned, express prices. But for the promotion of the renewable energy, the government has said, and the central regulator has said, or the regulatory commission has said, that there'll be no transmission charges, but the procurer will have to absorb the losses. And I've given the losses, that interstate losses. So that is the losses say around that by that percentage you have to sort of increase that. Then there is an option available, which is the spot market, and you see that information that in the spot market the price fluctuates from 1.85 rupees to about 3 rupees, and the instances when it is available, they are all narrated in terms of the percentages. So it will give you a feel of that what is if alternatively, instead of procuring a long-term basis from a producer, if I go to the spot market, then what is the likely price that I'm likely to get? And also there is a possibility that at some instances it may not get scheduled because there could be transmission congestion. There'll be additional price of 0.7 paisa per unit. That is you have to pay to the power exchange. So collectively this is something, the cost that gets established. There is another possibility for the distribution utility is to procure a similar amount of megawatt from a thermal generating unit, which you have a long-term PPA, but in general you're not scheduling it for various reasons. So that can supply additional units, and there is a 10 paisa per unit charge by the government in terms of environmental and other tax, because government is trying to discourage or sort of socialize the environmental cost. So it is sort of imposing this cost to be borne by the procurer of conventional energy. Can you come down, please? So this is what is the current situation, that you know there's a KLM solar company which has offered to buy to sell 10 megawatt of solar energy at ₹250 per unit, which is at the state periphery because it is located within the state, and but it is seeking counter guarantees for the payment security as payment security, and from the state government, because there have been instances where distribution licensee has defaulted on the payments. So it says that I'll supply ₹250, but the state has to counter guarantee, provide a counter guarantee that if the distribution licensee doesn't pay up, then the state will pay for the default, you know, so it will take over the default. Also important is that, you know, all these renewable energy is exempted from government taxes and other levies. The other information that has been provided is that, you know, it is located within the state, and it's located in an area where the distribution licensee is currently.
Sir, I have to interrupt you for a moment. I mean, if you can speak a bit in a, I mean, because you're too fast, you know.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, sir, thank you.
No, sorry. I had this time foundation in my mind, so I was just trying to finish up with you. So there is another situation which is connected with this procurement, that the solar plant is located in an area where currently the distribution licensee have congestion and voltage issues, and consequently the consumers are facing issues around because of the availability of the voltage and you know the load disruption. So if this 10 megawatt is procured at that point or at that interconnection point, this will help to alleviate those voltage and other you know problems. So now the crux of this petition is that the distribution licensee, which is regulated, has filed a petition before the commission saying that we wish to do this, and along with it the state government is also a party. What state government says that if because looking at the price, if there is any saving which accrues to the distribution licensee, that saving should be utilized for reducing the tariffs of the lifeline consumers. So whatever the saving is, you know, it should not be spread to all the consumers, but it should be passed on to the lifeline consumers, meaning that this part is becomes in a sort dedicated to the domestic and the lifeline consumers. So now the commission has scheduled a hearing, and every stakeholder is present here, and the distribution licensee is going to make a presentation before the commission, and people have will be as per the permission of the commissioner, the commissioner of, and the chairman of the commission would be allowed to make a presentation or make a point. Thank you.
So okay, now Arun, because yes, this is a hearing, so you are giving them time, and if they want to understand any point, because here two three points which are very important for the participant, they have to first that know that whether there is a demand for electricity or not. So DISCOM has a demand, it is explained that 1% is you know required, then what kind of price, what is the price, then you have to see that what will be the delivered price. Delivered price is very important with consideration of the losses, because when you see that losses and add in the you know price which is given your state periphery, so you have to I think add the intrastate loss. Vivek will clarify it if it is because he has spoken that intrastate losses are I think 13% or so, so that can be added in that. And then RPO is lagging, I think there is a deficit in RPO, so you have to see that okay, shortfall in the RPO is being paid as a 1.50 rupee per unit for either the certificate or as a penalty. It means it has a opportunity cost. Yeah, somebody want to say? Okay, so 1.50 rupee is being paid by the distribution company. So to avoid this, if he purchase any renewable energy, then I think this 1.50 rupee will be saved. So this is also an opportunity cost which can be saved. So this is also very important. Then the losses and the spot market. He says the spot market is also there. So suppose if we do not purchase renewable energy, instead of that you go to spot market. But spot market is always uncertain. This is also to be kept in mind that spot market is always you know uncertain. You cannot base on long term basis. So here the case is being given to you. You will study it and discuss among your group, among your group members, and then one of you or you know two, they can prepare some small short notes, and then they will be given time to speak before the regulatory body, and finally the regulatory body decide the matter. Okay, thank you.
Professor Ridham Singh would like to now say that how we are moving to the groups, please.
Yes, sir. So meanwhile, as this case was being presented and all the members had joined, so at the back end, we have already assigned you to the different breakout groups as per the priorities indicated by you in the Google Forms. So now as we will, in a few very short, just in a few moments or a few minutes time, we will be activating those breakout groups. And once we activate it from our end, you will be allocated to your respective group. One thing please take care is that, just as a sort of reconciliation or, please be confirmed that if you suppose there is a problem at your end, suppose there is internet connectivity issue or there is some other issue due to which accidentally you drop out of the meeting, or the meeting ends at your end, and you again restart the meeting and rejoin the meeting. So rest assured that when you rejoin, though you will come to this main meeting only, but there will be a link at the top of your screen which will say that if you want to join that respective room or the breakout group in which you were already there before you dropped out of the meeting. So you just click on that link and you will again go back to the same breakout group where you were already discussing it. So there is no need to panic. If you drop out, you can again rejoin and go to the respective group. Just mute themselves. Okay, so that is, it's very easy and smooth thing. We'll be controlling it from our end. And from your end, only problem might come in case of some internet connectivity issue. So, but as I said, there is no need to panic. You can go to your group just through clicking the link at top of the screen when you join the meeting again. Right.
Professor Ritan Singh.
And also those who could not be assigned. Yeah, one second. Those who could not be assigned, those that joined it, please stay here. We will join. We will assign you the way. When you speak out, we will assign you there, please. So now, as Professor Ritam saying, no panic. Let us shift it. And we will, please understand, there we will have only 25 minutes. So a navigator and among you, you can decide. So one of us also will be there. So Naiti, Professor Ritam Singh, we can now start.
Yeah. So admin, you can start
open the groups.
Okay. Yes, please. Open the room, please. It will take 10 seconds to reach. Normally it takes 10 seconds to go there.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hello, assalamu alaikum. I cannot hear any activity ongoing. Are we on hold?
Can you please tell me your name?
Hasib Shah.
Okay, can you please tell me your required group, preferable group, can you please tell me?
Utility.
Oh, okay, utility.
Hello, I'm also can see anything, so if you can add me into...
Yeah, hello, please, can you tell me your, please tell me your name and your preferable group.
My name is Faiza Khatri and my preferable group is a project developer.
Okay, ma'am, just to give me a second. Faiza Khatri.
Yeah.
Okay, your group?
Project Hello? Developer.
Okay.
Hello, ma'am. Please, can you add me in the project developer group? My name is Bilal.
Okay, just give me a minute.
अरे सर भेज तो दिया सर देखे ये
हर मेन में
सर मेन में तो इतने सारे हैं पर इन्होंने रजिस्टर
I'm still waiting for my group.
Hello, same here. Still waiting for my group as well.
Hello, anyone there from admin?
Can you please tell me your name?
My name is Bilal and my...
You have already assigned a group. Can you
but
please
I'm
see
not in the group.
There should be an option, join room.
No, I can't see the option.
Hello, I'm not in a group either at the moment, and I can't see any options to join.
From our side, we have already assigned a group to you. There should be an option of join room. I don't know what is the problem from your side. All the members have been shifted to their preferable rooms.
Hello. I do not see any option either.
Where are we supposed to look for the option, ma'am? Please, can you tell?
Can I speak to admin?
Yes, please tell me.
Yeah, I'm Sheriff Dean from Sri Lanka. I'm supposed to be regulatory group, but I don't see members in the regulatory group in my screen.
What is that preferable group?
Regulatory.
Sorry? Regulatory?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Sure.
Hello, can I speak?
Hello.
Yeah, please tell me.
Yes, ma'am. Susan Azhar from Nepal. I am representing from government group.
Kamesh sir, I've already shifted you to the required group.
Hello, which group I am in? I'm Gamage. Isanka Gamage.
I cannot see you.
Hello, can you hear me? Hello, admin. Hello.
Hello, admin. I'm still waiting as well. Can you hear me?
Hello.
Hello, yes, please tell me your name.
I'm Nishanka Gamage.
Sir, we have already shifted you to the government group. Maybe there should be an option of
utility group. I was assigned utility group.
One second, Kamesh ka dekh.
Yes, utility group. I was earlier in.
Kamesh, energy, energy. Just wait for a second.
Yeah. I'm Sangha Gamage in utility group as your earlier letter email.
Utility group. In which group you want to go?
No, I was posted to utility group in your email. You sent an email in the morning.
Yeah. Can you tell me your preferable group, please?
Utility is okay.
Okay. Okay.
Ma'am.
Yeah. Hello.
Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am. Kashif Muni is here. Can you add me in utility? Hafiz Muhammad Kashif Muni. Can we add the utility, please?
Starting name, can you tell me your starting name?
Hafiz Muhammad Kashif Muni.
Hafiz Muhammad. Okay, okay. Your preferable group?
Utility, please.
Okay, just give me a minute.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, admin. Hello, admin.
One second. Hi, yeah, please tell me.
Yes, Uthman here. I am in a customer group.
Utility.
But, please add me in the customer group, please. I am the vendor.
Sorry?
I am Uthman. I am a solar vendor. We are a solar EPC company. Can you add me to the customer group? The first group.
Okay, okay, sure. Uthman in customer group.
Right. Uthman Farooq.
You have already assigned in the customer group.
Yeah.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, please.
My name is Soha and I still cannot see any option to join any group.
Your preferable group, ma'am?
Utility.
Okay, one second.
Thank you.
Soha. Soha Utility. SOH. Ma'am, Soha, ma'am,
SUHA.
SUHA, okay. utility. Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, hello, everyone. Yeah, please.
My name is Irshad. Can you add me to the customers group, please?
Irshad, okay. Sure. Any other? Can you please?
Hello. Yes, ma'am. I'm Mohammed Fridul Samad Oppo.
Sorry, please.
I was in financial institute group, but unfortunately, I got disconnected. So kindly help me to join this group again.
Hello, ma'am. Can you please assign me to a project developer group?
Yeah, please tell me your name.
My name is Bilal.
Bilal, your preferred group?
Project developer.
You have already assigned in the group, sir.
But hello, my name is Sandun. My name is Sandun. I also want to join the project developer group.
Your name?
Sandun Talagala.
Sorry, spelling. Can you please tell me?
S-A-N-D-U-N.
S-A-N, okay. Project developer group.
I want to add
okay,
to the
okay.
Project developer.
Okay. Hello, can you hear me? Yeah, please. Yes, my name is Sorry, I can't hear you.
Can you please speak loud? I can't hear you. My name is Muhammad Uzair. I'm supposed to be in project developer group.
Okay, Muhammad Uzair. Your name? Muhammad?
Muhammad Uzair. Uzair.
I'm supposed to be in the project development group. Can you add me there, please?
Thank you.
Hello, admin.
Yes.
I'm still not added to the group. My name is Irshad.
Irshad, your preferable group? Customer.
Customer.
Okay. Okay, sir. We are signing.
Admin. Hello, admin. Hello, admin.
Hello.
Yeah, I am Sharif D. I am still not added to any group, I think.
Your name?
Sharif D.
Spelling, can you please?
SHARIFDWE.
Okay. One second, let me check. SHA.
I'm supposed to be the regulatory group.
Yes, sir, you have already assigned in the group.
Join it.
Assign karke ek baar dobara assign karo.
Hello,
man. Yeah, please tell me your name.
Yeah, Usman Farooq. I am unable to see any group assigned to me against my name.
Can you see a join room option in the above panel?
Let me check. Join room. Nope. Unable to see it.
Usman, okay. Your preferable group? Usman, your preferable group is customer?
Customer group.
Sir, utility wala utna. Ek
Dr. Qureshi, I think I should ask them everybody to come back.
Yes, sir. We can wait for another 5 minutes, I believe, and then we can perhaps, you know.
All right.
So, but please, if you can tell Mr. Anand Kumar that it should not be more than the regulatory, you know, this session should not be more than 20 minutes, right?
Okay, I'll speak
to him. Once the hearing will be started here, because we need to take out of time, and it's better that we have it for 20 minutes.
Okay. All right.
Hello.
Hello. Okay. Yeah, no. Yes. Lang din ang kata, kaling kata karo. Then nang wala ni react na mami body wala kini, mapasi ka na mami eat na kini.
Professor Ritam, you ask Priya to close it.
Yes, sir. I've told her one or two groups are, I think, are just remaining. She is closing those.
No, let everybody come, otherwise we cannot start here.
Okay, sir.
Let them forcefully come in, because we don't have that much time. In next 15 minutes, 20 minutes, we have to close this session.
questions for the discourse.
Yeah.
So these are seen as these are being met.
Okay.
And
okay.
Are you being deployed?
Chaliye. Okay. Who will start?
And we are already back into the main session, right?
Have you, Arun?
All. Not all.
Okay. Right. So, sir, in terms of what are the ground rules right now? Because if this, regulatory proceedings goes on, all the representatives of these group leaders will be there, they will be switching on their webcams.
Yes, they should do that. Right. And Professor Anand Kumar, you can give them time one by one. Now, there are five, 20 minutes.
20 minutes, in 20 minutes, everyone here have to speak, everyone.
Yeah, they will speak two, three minutes.
The whole session will go, the whole hearing will go for 20 minutes, not more than that. This is what I
okay, theek hai, chaliye, public hearing is so okay. We are going to have a public hearing. And first of all, I would give the chance to consumers group. Who will speak from the consumer side?
Yes, Abu Bakar here. I will speak on behalf of customer group.
Okay.
So we have noted down after the discussion some points that we will raise in the hearing. That first point is with the respect to obviously the reliability. We customers need the reliability and uninterruptible supply. So as per our thoughts, that this solar is only available in the morning. So what is the backup plans of the distribution company? How they can have the load or generation in the night? Second thing is this solar is also very risky with respect to weather conditions. So what is the backup plan when there are any fluctuations in the generation? Next point is we want to see the distribution company investment plans with respect to transmission and distribution. But we have observed that they are procuring the generation only, but they did not have any investment plans in the distribution network. So one more point is in this study, we have observed that the cheapest electricity they are already purchasing is rupees 2.2 per unit. And as we know that this nowadays, this solar and wind renewable is the cheapest source, but they are purchasing this one on 2.4 per unit. So what are the justifications that why it is higher from the already procured energy? And one more thing is, did they analyze, have any comparison with respect to procurement of this 20 megawatt thermal versus this solar? Because from the customer point of view, I think thermal is more stable for 24 hours and we can have the energy in the night. One point, missing points, we have observed that if we have more data with respect to DISCO's kind of health condition, like what are the network issues or load sheddings or and financial as well, so we can more comment that what are the improvement side, the customer needs. I think almost I have covered all the main points we have discussed.
Very good. Consumer group is good. Now the second group will be the financial institution.
So Mr. Satya.
Good afternoon to all. I'll be present pointing our remarks. Our conclusion is we are okay with this, but having said that, we also like to get some more information so that we can take a considerate view. We have first of all assumed two, three things that we'll be looking at investment financing the KLM Solar Company, which we assume that it is the sponsor or the developer of the project, and it has already in place arrangement for the, it has a sound tech like arrangement for the technology as well as good arrangement for the EPC contract and the OMN contract. Then we try to analyze the from the project from the SWOT point of view. The strength of the project, we understood that the situation, the demand is good. There is a growth in demand. The outlook is good. and the like local population requirement is there because there is a lot of congestion. So we anticipate or we feel that there may not be any issue regarding from the local population against the project. From the weakness point of view, we found that the we assume that it will be a long-term PPA, while the project PPA is fixed at 2.5 per unit. So we are like, since it's a long-term PPA and there is no such information or that is not linked to the market, so feed-in premium might have been a better one. So that we feel that it is not, it's a fixed one and not linked to the market. That may be an area of weakness. From the opportunity side, we feel that since solar is being now given great importance and for the environmental reason and for the recently whatever happened in the COP26 and all, so it's a priority for the federal as well as the state government. So I think support from the regulatory angle will be there. And okay. In opportunity that further these things will go up, and since the it is already requirement is 24 megawatt and we are only catering to 10 megawatt, so it is a good opportunity. So that is from the opportunity angle. From the threat angle, we are not very sure, but we also want to understand the location of the project, the quality of insulation and other areas, whether that area is prone to flood or some sandstorm or something which may affect efficiency of the project. So okay, with this information, we are okay with the project, but we need to revisit many of the other terms. Thank you.
Okay. You need more information, huh?
Yes.
Okay. Now project developer, KLM. Who is? Yeah, Papun Das.
Thank you, sir. I'm Papun Das from Project Developer. We have the company, KLM Solar Company. We want to develop the project for the solar and distributor company. And already, distributor company are procuring the solar price. Average price is the more than our proposed price. So if we procure our proposed price, then solar price average price will be lower. So it is benefit, or it is benefit of the DISCOM. And already floating market is higher than our proposed price. So floating market is not stable, but our long-term agreement is the stable one. So if you procure from our company, then you will be benefited. And you know, sir, in RPOs already 1.2% you should buy from the solar. And if you procure from our solar power plant, then you will get benefit 1.5 rupees per unit. And another point, sir, already you have procuring the solar from another solar companies. Their power plant is outside of the state, so their transmission loss is more than 13%. But our company is inside the state, so our solar transmission loss is very, very less. And you know, sir, solar is the environment friendly. So this is the benefit of this is the carbon. It can minimize the carbon.
Okay, good, very good, very good. Okay, now next group will be your utility company or the government. Let the government should take up first. Who is representing government?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I am Abrar Malik. I am representing the government group. So if you let me to share this screen.
You have made the presentation?
Yes.
Very nice. Good.
We have to go open share tray.
Government, yes. Windows. You are also behaving as a government, huh?
Taking yes.
So,
our group consists of many colleagues from across the SAARC countries. Dr. R.P. Dithal is our navigator, and I will lead the team, and deputy team lead will be Mr. Faisal Sharif.
Good.
So, about this case study, because we are representing the government side.
Yeah.
So, we have to watch the interests of the government. Mm. And in this regard, what we have, our key area of interest in this PPA are policy and RPO obligation, which we have found that these are being met because government wants deployment of renewable energy sources. And that's why every DISCOM has certain obligations to meet. And in this regard, yes, we are fine. But we don't know at the moment the net gain effect. This must be quantified, including transmission losses networks, that at what cost this will be purchased and supplied to the consumers, because government has to watch the interests of the consumers as well to make the affordable electricity for them. And at the same time, government is also interested to unfold the procurement procedure of this offer, whether this has been, transparency has been ensured or not, and value of money for customers has been taken into account or not. How it this has been procured, is this is a first come first serve offer, whether there was auction, there was competition or not. This is not clear to us at the moment from this case study. Then of course, government is also interested to know about the RPPA obligations, which the government has to fulfill, because the investors are asking for government guarantees because DISCOM's failure in the past to make payments. So government is interested, first of all, to know the term period of and type of the contract. Term period means that this DISCOM has remaining 20 years of the license period, and whether the upcoming project, this under construction, is being coming within that 20 years limit or not, and what type of contract it is. It's short term, long term, 24 hour based, or it's auction based, it's time slot based. So these things need to be further clarified and presented by the petitioner. And then there will be, of course, risk share mechanism. Government has also take some obligation of the DISCO because these are state-owned entities at the end. So what kind of risks are being passed on to the government? Because government would like to go for minimum risk sharing from its side, because it has already exempted taxes, duties on renewable energy things, etc. So then whether there are all the NOCs or permits of the government, whether land is available to them or not, what are the terms and conditions, all the foreign expatriates will move in into this project, the other requirements, have these been satisfied or not. Then of course is the payment security. And one thing more about the subsidy side, because to provide electricity at the minimum, because government also intends to reduce its subsidy quantum, which is being given to the lifeline consumers. So government is interested to know the what will be the net gain in this, whether there will be saving for the government exchequer or not. So these are the key findings and key areas of interest which we have so far looked into in the limited time. And we have reached to the conclusion and for recommendation to this August forum that further analysis and quantification of all types of options, whether these are legal or financial and as well as technical, needs to be performed for taking well-informed decision maybe in the next hearing. Thank you very much.
Okay. Okay, so you want next hearing, huh?
Yeah.
Let utility be given the chance, and if we will able to reply everything whatever raised here today, the commission may like to decide today. Yeah, utility. Who is representing utility?
Hello. Good afternoon, everyone.
Yeah.
Thank you for giving us this opportunity. I will take some input from my co-leader with Emma Sifat, who's also taking care of the utility. Mm-hmm. So we have, being a utility leader, we would like to share our proposal for KLM Solar for the improvement of consumer in remote area. So as of case study, we given demand of 404 megawatt with increase of 2%, which becomes 408 megawatt. With this we can Mr. Agarwal, 400
only.
If you want, Sifat, you can continue. I will hear that. No problem.
Okay.
Maybe misspoke a little bit. We calculated 412, so the increase was 8.08 megawatt for this year.
8.8% increase.
So, sir, actually, our yearly estimated
1600.
Actually, no, our peak demand, sir. Actually, our peak demand is 404 megawatt.
Okay.
And our estimated growth for the next year is 2%. So our next year, we are estimating that our demand will be 412 megawatts. So, we need an additional 8.08 megawatt. So from that
so
point of view,
10 megawatt is okay. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Then what are the reply to the queries raised by the consumers group and the financial institution and developer group? Have you jotted it down?
Mr. Arangachap, should I continue or should you continue?
Mr. Sipal, you can continue, please.
Continue.
Okay, so actually I noted down some points, but actually some of the analysis will actually take time. But for today, we can answer some of the questions.
Okay, okay.
First of all, I want to show our from our point of view first, in the power plant that is being proposed is actually inside our state, in our state periphery. And in our state periphery, you know, the system stability is quite not as good as we expect. So this integration of this power plant will increase the system stability in our periphery side. It will increase voltage stability, and we are hoping that this will increase our customer satisfaction. And regarding our obligation to buy renewable power, the government has given us the obligation that we should get 3.6% of our energy from renewable sources, and otherwise we get 1.5 rupees of penalty for each unit. So currently in this year, we are estimating that we'll have to pay around 6 crore rupees of penalty just because of this obligation, because we are currently meeting only 1.2% of this. So we actually really need to increase our renewable energy share. We have calculated that if we take this proposal, if we are able to integrate this power in our system, then we will be able to get, assuming a 20% capacity utilization factor, we'll get 17.52 million units of electricity from this company. Which will save about 2.62 crore rupees penalties. Currently, this penalty, this huge penalty, is actually indirectly going to the consumers. So actually, we want to meet the government's demand to give the mandatory RPO cap, in a step to meet that, we really want to take renewable power, and this proposal from KLM Group is actually will be very good for our system and the consumers. And regarding some questions that was asked by the consumers, especially the consumers showed some concerns about what will happen due to the variations of solar and in nighttime. So for now, taking this solar power plant does not mean that we will not integrate other sources also. We are taking this solar power plant because we actually need to integrate some renewable energy. But of course, in the future, we will also complement it with other sources, which will be able to meet the demands at night also and complement this system.
Okay, now I will ask the regulatory staff to raise their viewpoint. What is their concern about this case? Yeah, regulatory authority.
After listening all this scenario, we have concluded that we have to see certain parameters like maximum power that is required in coming years. And the second major thing about
government preference and the new laws that have been developed for renewables. So first thing, we would like to conclude that there are two proposals, 20 and 10 megawatt. As per our utilities growth point of view, forecasting point of view, it's in coming years, it's less than 10 megawatt. So that means the preferable solution for us is to give go ahead for 10 megawatt, not 20 megawatt, because 20 megawatt is firstly thermal, secondly 10 megawatt is renewable, and second point for that renewable is it's within our range. Like if we will allow 20 megawatt purchase, that will be a bottleneck for supply chain, first point. Second point is this renewable, it's intrastate. So intrastate means we will not only get financial stability, but we will also get our grid stability, our short circuit level, voltage drop will be low. Okay. Third point, carbon taxes, those are being imposed recently after agreement for COP26. There are certain agreements, those are being conveyed to certain governments, to all around 100 governments, that carbon taxes and penalties for those who will carbon emission, who will release maximum carbon emissions, will have to face maximum penalties and carbon taxes. These are the actually three main things, and on the basis of these things, we can say that 10 megawatt from renewable is suitable for our system. Last thing that I would like to convey, that consumer has just highlighted that from thermal we will get from on 2.4 per unit, and on renewable it's around 2.5. But if you consider all the government taxes, carbon taxes, all the thermal losses, okay, and our forecasting, in that case, we can convey to consumers that 20 megawatt firstly is not as per our requirement, and in last 2.4 will not be 2.4 from thermal, it will be around at least 2.85 or $3 or rupees per unit. So from our side, we will definitely go for prefer 10 megawatt. And definitely we will also, after shortlisting this, we will go for certain shortlisting procedures and other things.
So I think
from regulator side, another question, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, we would like to know how they have reached this price, sir. Have they done it through mutual agreement or through competitive bidding? Because the current policy says all renewable energy should be procured through competitive bidding.
Yeah.
And the second question is that in the current pool of the utility, the minimum price is 2.20 rupees per kilowatt hour. From which source they are buying this least cost energy? If it is already from solar, then why the current proposal is at higher sides? Thank you.
Okay. Utility would like to reply?
Yes, we can reply. If you see that, we are currently procuring some of our solar power from the spot market, and the spot market varies greatly. If you can see our spot market, about 20% of the time, it remains below 2 unit, 2.2 to 2.2 rupees, 15% of time. But you can also see that for 25% of the time, the price goes above 3 unit. So yes, we can maybe for some time period get 2.2 rupees or 2 rupees per unit, but the spot market is actually extremely volatile. So, but in this case, we are getting a long-term PPA that will get 2.5 rupees per unit for a long time, and it's more reliable to us rather than the spot market, because as you know, because of the transmission congestions, it may happen that we can't even get the power from spot market, and it may, sometimes the prices go too high.
Okay, I think we have heard all the that, excuse me. Yeah, somebody else.
In addition, yeah. in adding to that, but if you take this 10 megawatt 240, that is not in the particular state, it is from the another state. So the, if you take it, so the, we have to get this intra state the losses also. Yeah. If we take that, it will come about 2.775, not
right,
the 2.4.
Yes, yes, you are right.
Second question is how they have reached this price here, 2.450 kilowatt rupees per kilowatt hour. Have they mutually agreed or through competitive agreement bidding?
Utility may reply. Utility, how you have discovered this price?
Yeah, actually, if I go off meeting for a little bit, because we actually got, as you know, we actually in our case study, the detailed information even to us was not available, if you know. But
you can always say that you have tried for competitive bidding. You can say that you have tried for competitive bidding, but there was no, you know, bidders, or the, you know, participation was not, you know, there. So we have to select only one, and the price is reasonable. Yeah. You can just put this point.
Yeah, so
so from the regulator perspective, sir, if they have done any comparative study with the neighboring state, like, you know, to determine price, like
so you are from regulatory,
from utility side, we can say in this particular area, no, that supply is remote area, so voltage problems and also that also be solved. We can get approval, actually. We can submit our case better with this offer.
I think they have spoken about it. They have already said this.
This particular area is competitive bidding.
I think we have done a very good deliberation. And the only concern for us as a regulator is that, okay, the competitive bidding is necessary, because as per the law, you have to follow the law. And from future, you have to see that all the procurements should be done through competitive bidding and well in time. You have to make a concrete composite proposal and give it to the regulator, not for a piecemeal basis. You have to work it out for another 5 years and just work it out through the competitive bidding. So this is our request to you. And the second issue is very important, that since you are going for the solar, and the public has raised this issue that, okay, solar time is only daytime, what will happen to night time? So you can also work it out, some kind of demand response or some time of day tariff, so that the shifting of demand should also toward daytime. So you will have less demand during evening hours or peak hours. So this will also save money, and you can go more for the solar energy, because solar or renewable energy will be better for the society and better for the public. So the public concern is that they should get cheaper source. And I think with this proposal, there is no additional cost to the consumers. It is well below the average power purchase cost. So, but since there are a lot of questions raised by the government and the regulatory staff, so we will have another round of meeting. And in the meantime, you collate all this information and submit to the all the stakeholders. Like, you can place it on your website, so this data or this information will be assessed by all the people who have participated in the hearing. So we will fix some another round of hearing next day. Arun Kumar?
Right.
Arun Kumar.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for this wonderful, and I hope that the participants have really enjoyed this session, especially going to the breakout groups and then coming back.
From the IPP, we are the project developer. You know, sir, one sun, one earth. And if you procure from the conventional power plant, we are producing the gases. So we have to save. So please, procure have to be safe. So we hope you can procure from our power plant.
Right. Thank you so much.
And thank you so much, Professor Ankumar, for chairing this mock session. And thank you so much to all the leaders and the teams associated with all the groups for this wonderful discussion, a healthy discussion. Indeed, this session was really an interactive session and one of its kind. So now we can take a short break of 5 minutes and then we'll come back for the panel discussion session. So we have six panelists lined up for our next session, in which they will be discussing primarily on the competitive markets and the role of PPAs. And also, I would like to say that the participants will be getting the chance to speak with all the panelists and ask the questions. So this will also be a very healthy discussion. So please stay tuned, and we'll be back in next 5 minutes to start formally the panel discussion session. Thank you, and let's be back in 5 minutes. Thank you.